Tour. In 1060 KDUS Tempe, Phoenix. And KSLX HD2 Scottsdale, Phoenix.
Coming right up, another fun varsity sports show.
In 2019, the JV Sports Show podcast began with the idea of spotlighting young people in our community. In time, that podcast evolved into radio, television, and live stream, and through that evolution, new ideas have enhanced delivery, giving a stage to students both in front of and behind the microphone in Arizona and beyond. Thank you for supporting the Varsity Sports Show, now the Varsity Media Foundation, a 501c3 educational organization.
Hey, this is Sophie, and you're listening to my dad, Vince. Dad, you owe me $20 now.
Hi, kids. This is DJ Soulman from the Funk Junkies, and you're listening to the Varsity Sports Show with my man, Vince Delisio.
And Vince, what's your last name?
It's Delisio.
Okay, that's right. That's what I thought.
Yeah, right.
AM 1060 KDUS Tempe, Phoenix, and KSLX HD2 Scottsdale, Phoenix.
This program is paid for by the Varsity Media Foundation, a 501c3 nonprofit educational organization, and its partners.
You're listening to the Varsity Sports Show, home of Arizona's youth, high school, college sports, and you, empowering education and enabling dreams, right here on KDUS AM 1060 in Arizona. And now, welcome to the Varsity Sports Show.
Welcome to the Varsity Sports Show on AM 1060 KDUS Arizona. Sorry, we're doing live radio today, folks, and we got a little audio issue. My name is Vince Delisio, and I am your captain for this journey for the next 2 hours. Thanks so much for joining us. We are at Grand Canyon University, and we're doing a broadcast. What a morning we have here, ladies and gentlemen, as we pilot our connection. We were good to go, and all of a sudden we lost everything. It's comical. Anyway, we're out at GCU here at the Student Center. We got a big show today. We got a lot of things going on. We have some special co-hosts with us, some guest hosts with us. We have Nash Dara. We've got Alyssa Firestone. Guys, how's it going this morning?
It's a little bit chilly outside, but it's doing good. I'm excited to be here. It's a beautiful Saturday morning here in Arizona, and I'm excited to be on the show for the first time.
Yeah, well, we're excited to have you. What a day. What an adventure this is going to be. We've got a big show planned today. We've got a lot of activity, a lot of things going on out here, and it's going to make for a great show this morning. We are going to be doing several things. We have a bunch of segments, as we normally do. We've got some live features. We've got our friends from the Saguaro Sabercats. Coach Lucas Ramirez will be joining us. Coach Andy Johnson will be joining us as well. We have Coach Mandy Carson. We've got Coach Tim Kish. That name may ring a bell to you. He was the former interim head football coach at University of Arizona a while back. And has coached all around the country. He's putting together a special sports showcase that is a real special event for young people, and that'll be in a couple of weeks, and we're going to talk to Coach Kish about that. We are also going to be doing some other things out there, as well as in our second hour. Our second hour, as you know, is a national program, nationally syndicated on the Sports Map Radio Network. A lot of good stuff, a lot of fun. We've got our buddy Aaron Decker in the studio who's going to be managing the board for us as we work through our audio technical difficulties. I'm told that we're being picked up pretty good right now, so we're going to keep our fingers crossed that we manage this throughout the morning. And aside from that, I want to go to our co-hosts here, Nash and Alyssa. Alyssa, student at the Cronkite School of Journalism and Mass Communications at Arizona State University. Alyssa, what have you been doing for us this semester?
So far, I've been doing a lot of sports coverage and covering different games, a lot of interviews. I'm really enjoying it. It's been really fun so far.
How about you, Nash? What have you been up to?
Yeah, so I'm a junior at Cronkite, and this is my first time interning with the Varsity Sports Show, and it's been a blast so far. It involves covering certain high school games, doing play-by-play, color commentating, and production side of things, and it's just been a great opportunity for me, and I'm super happy to be involved with it and now doing the radio show this morning.
Yeah, a lot of fun. And we're doing something a little different today. Nash, what do we have going on right after this show ends?
We are actually filming a rugby game. We're producing a GCU club rugby game this year for the first time this semester. And I'm going to be filming a part of that one. I'm not the biggest rugby guy in the world, but I'm looking forward to it. Getting some new opportunity.
Good stuff. Should be fun. I can't wait. We've got a lot of good adventures ahead of us today with rugby. GCU is going to be playing the University of Utah. Looking forward to covering that match. So good stuff there. And then, of course, the rest of the show this morning. So make sure you guys stick around. Don't go anywhere. And you guys are in for a real treat today. Should be a lot of fun. So... Alyssa, talk about some of the projects that you've had this semester. You broke a story for us a couple weeks ago. It was made major news. What was that?
Recently, there was the Opportunity Bowl, which was a football game that was to help college recruiters for football against Southern California and Arizona. It's a really good time. I did some sideline reporting and covered a story on it. It's a really good experience.
Nice. So the whole purpose of the Opportunity Bowl was the fact that we had kids come here from Southern California. We had Arizona kids playing for the chance to get looked at by some colleges and scholarships. We're going to take it right now to Mason Collins, who's got a great report on Arizona high school basketball. Aaron, take it away.
Hello, everybody. I'm Mason Collins, talking to you all about Arizona high school basketball. With just a few weeks left in the regular season, coaches are getting their teams prepared for postseason basketball. Within sight of winning the state championship, here are the highest-ranked men's and women's basketball teams in Arizona hoping to bring home the trophy. On the women's side, the number one-ranked team is the Xavier College Prep Gators. The Gators are 20-4 overall and are 6-1 in regional play. The team got off to an undefeated season at 12-0 before suffering three straight losses to out-of-state opponents. Their one in-state loss was last week to Hamilton. Besides that, the team has been rolling through their schedule. They finished the regular season undefeated at home after picking up a win Tuesday night versus Chandler. The team overall is loaded with plenty of talent. Dominique Neslin, who is the senior captain on the team, joined the 1,000-point club this season. Neslin is currently committed to High Point University. She and the team will be set on winning the program's first state championship. With an extended amount of competition on the men's side, the Perry Pumas are still ranked number one in the state. With just three games left on the schedule, the Pumas are hoping to finish the regular season strong. With a record of 15-6, the defending back-to-back state champions are poised on winning their third straight. One of the top recruits in the 2025 class, Koa Pete, is making his name known as one of the top players in the state. In the state championship game last year versus Sunny Slope, Pete dropped 35 points. Until Perry goes down in the postseason, this team remains as a standard to beat. Make sure to tune in to Arizona High School Basketball with Varsity Sports. This is Mason Collins.
Hey, what's up, everyone? Welcome to another segment of Varsity Sports Show. I'm Diego Fernandez. Brand new sports team enters Las Vegas' domain within the 702, introducing none other than the Las Vegas Frills professional volleyball team. The The team, as well as six others, joined the inaugural season of not only the Thrills, but the league in itself. The Pro Volleyball Foundation was announced back in 2022, but did not plan to take course until 2024. Las Vegas Thrill will find its new home in Dollar Loan Center to take on its inaugural season. Thrills will be starting off the inaugural season on the road to take on Omaha Supernovas on February 7th, and then a couple of days later, they'll take on the Orlando Valkyries. The Thrill won't put on their first home game until February 19th, but nonetheless, this is just another professional sports team added to the city of Sin. Thrill head coach Fran Foroy spoke to KTNV, the local Las Vegas ABC affiliate, about how she feels to coach a brand new team and how it feels to coach in a city like Las Vegas.
Well, I think the city is a perfect match. I mean, volleyball is thrilling, right? No pun intended. It's an amazing, amazing sport. Vegas is primed to become, if it's not already, the sports capital of the world, right? I mean, it's pretty incredible what's happening in Vegas, and to be on the cusp of that happening in Vegas and on the cusp of bringing professional volleyball to the United States, it's a perfect marriage.
Number 12, Berkeley Oblad is a local as it gets, being from Las Vegas' own Coronado High School. And much eyes will be looking out for her to see what impact she makes on the team and, of course, the city. From Varsity Sports Show, this is Diego Fernandez.
Good morning. I'm Eitan Ohana with the Varsity Sports Show. The Miami Dolphins are in the midst of their search for a new defensive coordinator after former coordinator Vic Fangio and the team went separate ways. What was at first a surprise to Dolphins fans now makes more sense since reports of a fracture between Fangio and members of the organization came out. Miami, and head coach Mike McDaniel specifically, now turned their attention to finding a long-term solution for the role, someone that will lock down that side of the ball for years to come. The Dolphins have not limited their search to one type of candidate. In fact, reported candidates have a wide range of age and experience. Among the more seasoned candidates are two former head coaches and defensive coordinators, Brandon Staley and Leslie Frazier. Staley was the head man for the Los Angeles Chargers up until late this past season, when he was let go from the position. Frazier was most recently the defensive coordinator for the Buffalo Bills, before he left on his own volition in 2022. There are also some young, fresh candidates that the Dolphins are taking a look at. This includes the likes of Houston Texans linebackers coach Chris Kiffin and Baltimore Ravens defensive line coach Anthony Weaver. In-house candidates the Dolphins are reportedly looking at include current linebackers coach Anthony Campanile and current outside linebackers coach Ryan Slowick. For Varsity Sports, I'm Eitan Ohana.
HD Radio is here for KDUS AM 1060. Check out your favorite shows and games on 100.7 KSLX HD2.
APAC is your one-stop source for all your automotive and heavy-duty air conditioning parts, supplies, and equipment. They're family-owned and have been the Valley's go-to for all your auto AC needs since 1982. Whether it's for your everyday or vintage car, commercial, or off-road vehicle or equipment, APAC has you covered. Call APAC, AAPAK, the AC experts at 602-254-1116 and ask for the Varsity Special to get 10% off your purchase.
Training Better Athletes was founded by renowned football coach Ron Sowers with the philosophy of training well-rounded young people in mind and body. TBA is the go-to for middle schoolers through the pros. Coach Sowers has worked with all sports but specializes in football offensive and defensive line skills training. Whether it's one-on-one or group training, reach out to Coach Sowers at trainingbetterathletes.com or call him at 602-435-9064. You can't cheat the grind.
Hey, local businesses, join the Varsity Sports Show and promote your business on our weekly radio show and game live streams. We have several options to promote your business affordably and reach our incredible audience. Call, text, or email us anytime if you'd like more information on joining our team. The Varsity Sports Show will work hard to promote your business through our audio and video platforms while also promoting all of our young people. 480-779-9437 or email us at varsitysportsshow.com. Hey guys, Vince here to talk about Angel Dentistry. It's where my wife and I have gone for over 10 years, and we trust them with our routine and extensive dental care because they care. Dr. Amber Angel is an Arizona native, born in the town of Miami, and has been practicing in the Valley over 20 years. For general to comprehensive dental services, call 602-788-2008. Located off of Cave Creek Road, just north of the 101 in North Phoenix, Angel Dentistry, proud supporters of our young people and proud partners of the Varsity Sports Show.
Ready to bring KTUS AM 1060 into your home with Alexa?
Hi, I'm Alexa.
Download the KTUS AM 1060 skill and enable.
Then say, Alexa, open KTUS AM 1060.
This is where I start my day.
You're listening to the home of Saguaro Sabercat Basketball. The Varsity Sports Show, AM 1060, KDUS, Arizona. And now, here's Coach Lucas Ramirez. Welcome back to the Varsity Sports Show, AM 1060, KDUS, Arizona. Vince Delisio. And guys, we're out at the Grand Canyon University Student Center. Outside the Student Center, there's like, how many people here? Half the campus is out here. For our show. No, they're not here for our show, but there's a breakfast going on, and they just happen to be here as well. I want to send a shout-out, a big thank you to GCU Club Sports Information Director Jim Howell. He's an old Phoenix College guy. He set this up for us, and we are out here, and it's a lot of fun, a lot of bright, cheery faces this morning. So anyway, so come on out. If you're in the area, come on out. We're joined on the line by the architect, the master of what was arguably the greatest three quarters that I'd ever seen of high school basketball just the other night. And it was against St. Mary's. It was Saguaro. Coach Lucas Ramirez. Coach, how are you, sir?
Good morning. Doing good. I got to say one thing. Jim Howell was the SID at Phoenix College when I was an assistant there for a couple of years. And he is, you won't find a better guy. Jim is the best.
I gotta
throw that out there. But
yeah, he's a legend. He didn't hear you, but he'll hear it on the replay later. So yeah, he's definitely a legend. I'll make sure and tell him. No, for sure. So Coach, big game the other night. You guys were leading at half. You made a run in the fourth quarter. Unfortunately, the third quarter was not quite what you were expecting. How optimistic did you come away with after that game?
Yeah, you know, overall it was a pretty good week for us. You know, we started the week against Marco Sneza, and you know, it's hard to win reach basketball games at any level and your conference games at any level. And we did a good job taking care of business at home, and you know, we carried that momentum into our road trip at Lake Havasu on Tuesday night. Had a big win there, so you know, I think we had a lot of positivity and mojo going on, and you know, we carried that into a St. Mary's game. You know, number one team in 4A, and it just shows our guys are confident. You know, they won't back down to anybody, which is great. And that's the kind of momentum that we want heading into the postseason.
Sweet. So I heard you just talking about the Lake Havasu game. This is Nash Darrow with the Varsity Sports Show. And I just want to ask, how do you prepare your team for a game that's kind of 2 hours away from you? And, I mean, I played high school sports, so I remember those fun bus rides. But especially after a win, how exciting is it to get a win on such a long game?
Cool. It certainly makes the bus ride back easier. That's for darn sure. But no, I mean, like I told the fellows, you know, earlier in the week leading up to it, like this is a business trip and we gotta treat it like such. You know, so our guys were pretty dialed in on the bus ride over, whether they were kind of zoned out on music or their phone or whatever. You know, so it's pretty quiet bus ride up. Everyone's pretty focused or sleepy probably. And then, you know, that bus ride back is fun. You know, you grab some In-N-Out burger, and it makes the trip home a little quicker.
Coach, this is Alyssa Firestone with the Varsity Sports Show, and I'm curious. I heard you guys are going to playoffs. What does it look like for you guys to prepare for playoffs for your
Yeah, well, you know, so our season, regular season ended on Wednesday. You know, the official regular season of the AIA doesn't end until next Thursday. So we won't find out our opponent until Friday. So we have essentially 2 weeks before we play a game and a week before we find out our opponent. So we actually gave our guys off Thursday, Friday, and this morning. And then we'll get back to work on Monday and have a couple days of practice, give them a day off again, and then get back to it as we kind of build toward the playoffs, finding out who our opponent is. And then, you know, once we get our opponent, it's watching film, breaking it down, doing a scouting report, and figuring out how we can, take advantage of our opportunity, you know, and that's what it's all about. That's the great thing about postseason basketball. It's a new life, a new season, and you know, a new opportunity to make something happen.
Yeah, that was just that's just what I was going to ask, actually. So you obviously have some off time, and I was going to ask about if you give your team a break or, like, for practices, how long or how often are you guys practicing, especially before a big game come playoff games?
Say that one more time. Sorry, you broke out.
Yeah, how often are – so I was kind of asking about, like, preparing for the playoff game, and you kind of just talked about that, but are practices different compared to playoffs during regular season? Can you feel the intensity in the gym when you're practicing?
Yeah, I mean, I think you have to. If your guys aren't excited to work hard and compete at this time of the year, then, your team's probably not in a good place. And we always talk about playing our best basketball in January, February, you know, for us. And that's what we've been doing, you know. And anyone who's followed us, you know, that's kind of how our team's been this year. We keep getting better and we keep playing hard. And, our practices every year are a little shorter as the season goes on just to make sure our guys rest. And, you know, it's easy in October to have two-hour practices before you play a game. But, you know, at this point in the year, we want to be very efficient with our time and you know, practice for hour and a half at the most. Some days might just come in and shoot, you know, for 45 minutes. But just being very efficient with what we do is very important this time of the year.
All right. And also, so you guys finished the year at 9:15. You guys had a very hard schedule this year, but can you just give kind of a brief recap of the season and some of the highs and lows of the year? And what do you take away from a season like this?
Absolutely. All positives. You know, it's based, if you look out and you look at our team, you see freshmen starting, two sophomores starting, and then a couple juniors who with very little varsity experience. So a young team that was learning throughout the year and kept getting better. And, you know, I think we arguably have one of the tougher schedules in 4A. The reason we're in the postseason is because we've had some tough opponents. And you play St. Mary's twice, Mesquite twice, AOA, Gilbert North, Dysart. Keep going down the list. Teams that are highly ranked in 4A or in the open division. So there's a reason we're battle tested, and there's a reason that I think we're going to be making a push in the postseason because we played tough opponents, and you know, that's just the reality. You know, a lot of your success is determined on your schedule. You know, kind of how that shakes out. You know, there's probably teams below us who've won more games, but quite frankly, I think we played a pretty tough schedule. So I think it's going to bode well for us as we move forward in the future. And also in the coming weeks.
All right, thank you, Coach.
We're
running out of time for you, so I appreciate you hopping on the call with us this morning. I'm going to give it back to Vince.
Coach, how do you like that? Normally we're a little more polite about it, but we got a hard stop here. So, Coach, it's been quite a season.
No, I get
anyway.
It. I get it, man. I could take up the whole 3 hours if you needed me to, but you never let me, so.
No, yeah, that's okay. Coach Lucas Ramirez, Saguaro Sabercat Report. Coach, we appreciate you, obviously, as always. Good luck as here heading into the postseason, and we'll circle back with you soon.
All right, thanks. Go Cats.
All right, take it away, Aaron.
Good morning, Arizona. My name is Alexandra Medina, and you are listening to KDUS AM 1060. Matt Stone, the head coach of the girls' flag football team at Hamilton High School in Chandler, Arizona, is the man behind the girls' flag football AIA sanction. After many years of advocating for girls' flag football, it has finally been sanctioned by the AIA during the year of 2024. Coach Stone has been working for over 10 years for the flag football AIA sanction in Arizona. A few of his students at his previous school asked Coach Stone if he would assist them in organizing a flag football team, and he agreed to do it, but with one requirement. The requirement was that it would be taken seriously.
all I care about is that every girl who desires to play this game in high school has a place to play.
A few years later in 2014, when Matt Stone became a teacher at Hamilton High School, he decided to create a girls' flag football program. When it was first created, they would only play a game or two with schools in the district. More teams began joining, but there were still not many. After years of speaking with the AIA, they finally decided to sanction girls' flag football during the year of 2024. Currently, there are 56 schools participating in running a girls' flag football program, but Matt Stone wants more.
I want to see in our state 200 high schools, just as they would with soccer, softball, basketball, and volleyball. I want to see 200 high schools field a team.
Coach Stone is nowhere near done contributing to growing the sport of girls' flag football in Arizona. Recently, the Arizona Cardinals expressed their appreciation for everything Coach Stone does for expanding the sport of girls' flag football by awarding him with tickets to Super Bowl 58. I'm Alexandra Medina, and you are listening to the Varsity Sports Show on KDUS AM 1060.
This is Angelo Scuturo with Varsity Sports Show. This past Sunday, we found out what two teams will be traveling to the 702 to battle for the Lombardi Trophy in Super Bowl 58. Of course, this is the first time the city of Las Vegas will be hosting America's biggest sports championship, which is expected to bring around 400,000 tourists during the big weekend. Looking for the cheapest ticket to sit close to the action at Allegiant Stadium? According to On Location, you're looking at a crisp $7,650 for seats all the way in the 400 level. And lower level seat prices are going in for a whopping $22,000. Strip hotel rates range from $400 to $1,100 for Caesars Entertainment properties, Harrah's having the cheapest rate while Caesars Palace has the most expensive rate. For the MGM properties, $530 to $1,850, Excalibur having the cheapest rate while Aria has the most expensive rate. For those wanting to choose an off-strip resort, downtown hotels estimate to about $400. Just in the course of the last 12 months, the city of Las Vegas have experienced a huge economic boom due to the F1 Grand Prix in November, which according to the Las Vegas Grand Prix, the impact to the area was $1.2 billion and drew 315,000 spectators. The Kansas City Chiefs will face off against the San Francisco 49ers in a rematch of Super Bowl 54 at Allegiant Stadium in Las Vegas on Sunday, February 11th. Kickoff will be at 3:30 p.m. with a halftime performance from R&B artist Usher. For Varsity Sports Show, Angelo Scuturo reporting.
Hi, I'm Ben Munawera with the Varsity Sports Show. So, conference weekend in the NFL was quite the spectacle for NFL fans, with the San Francisco 49ers and the Kansas City Chiefs advancing to Super Bowl 58 in Las Vegas, Nevada. Although Arizona fans didn't likely want to see a rival team make it to the big game, we're still going to be getting Arizonan representation, despite the Cardinals not being anywhere near the big game themselves. Two of the key players in the 49ers' big win over the Lions this last weekend were both homegrown Arizona talent. Quarterback Brock Purdy and wide receiver Brandon Ayuk. Brock Purdy, being the hometown kid, is from Gilbert, Arizona and attended Perry High School. We all know the story with Purdy already being Mr. Irrelevant, third-string quarterback, turned starter, turned Super Bowl incumbent quarterback, but adding the small-town kid aspect to it makes it so much more incredible for some reason. The people in Arizona love him, or you may hate him if you're a Cardinals fan. And then there's Brandon Ayuk. His wide receiver made the play of the game, catching a tip ball off of cornerback Kendall Vindor's helmet and setting up a touchdown that same drive that he would catch himself. Ayuk is an ASU alumni and played his best ball at the collegiate level when donning the maroon and gold, totaling 987 receptions for 1,666 yards and 11 touchdowns. And for the AFC Championship, we got to see Ravens tight end Mark Andrews return from a broken fibula he suffered midseason. And although he didn't have a great game statistically, neither did the Ravens team in general. So, it was just kind of nice to see the kid from Scottsdale make his return to the NFL. But don't you worry, Arizona. We still have Brock Purdy and Brandon Ayuk to show the world that homegrown talent can do it at the highest level from Arizona. Thanks for listening. This has been Ben Munawera for the Varsity Sports Show.
Need social information about KDUS AM 1060? Try KDUS1060.com at KDUS AM 1060 on Twitter and Facebook.com/KDUS AM 1060.
The Angry Crab Shack in Tempe, with an experience so good it remains indescribable, with something for every seafood lover. Try one of their amazing custom seafood boils, sandwiches, appetizers, and salads. Angry Crab Shack Tempe is located east of I-10 on Warner Road, 480-674-3847. The Angry Crab Shack in Tempe. Come ready to eat.
Hello, this is local voiceover model and former Daddy Yankee stunt double, Mario Malaby. Be sure to DM us your questions for Ask Lucas on Twitter. And you are listening to the Varsity Sports Show on AM 1060 KDUS, Arizona.
Hello everyone, my name is Jonathan Melendez. I am a senior at the Walter Cronkite School of Journalism and I am thrilled to join the Varsity Sports Show team as an intern for the spring 2024 semester, helping cover sports throughout the Valley. Can't wait to get started.
Your caddy, Ray Adams, takes you beyond the 18th hole on Saturday mornings with Great American Golf from 6 to 7 a.m. on KDUS AM 1060.
The Varsity Sports Show, AM 1060, KDUS Arizona. Vince Lucio here with Nash, Dara, and Alyssa Firestone. We're out at Grand Canyon University in front of the Student Center. We're joined by a special guest. Her name is Sarah. She's with GCU, and she's going to talk to us a little bit about what they had going on. I thought all these this 1,000 people that were out here were here to see us this morning.
Good morning, Sarah. Thank you for joining us, and thank you for setting this up, too. And I just have to ask, I was here very early. What time were you here this morning setting all this up? This looks like a lot of work.
5 a.m.
Wow, 5 a.m.
Right in early, before the sun was up.
I'm curious, how many people were here at this event? It looked like it was very crowded. Do you know roughly how many people showed up?
Yeah, I think about 250, 300.
Okay.
Yeah, good turnout.
Well, that's you gotta set up for a lot of people. That's a lot of work you need to do. But yeah, it's been a nice day outside, but I might have to go grab a cup of coffee here in a little bit.
Sarah, talk to us a little bit about what the actual event was. What was it that drew people out here? And not, don't say it was our show. But what was the actual event?
Yeah, totally. So Habitat for Humanity, you guys familiar with them? Yeah. We partner with GCU, and they come hang out on campus and pick up students and then take GCU students into the community to go fix up houses. And so it's kind of Habitat and GCU collab.
Very cool.
Yeah.
Perfect. Well, thank you for joining us, Sarah.
Thank you.
Thank you for those answers, and it was a pleasure having you this morning.
Thanks, guys. Have a good one.
Thanks so much. So that was so nice. And we didn't forget about Tim Kish, legendary coach Tim Kish, who's joining us. But I wanted to make sure and give Habitat for Humanity here on the campus at GCU a quick plug, because they're so gracious in allowing us to come out here and set up our show. But there's such a greater purpose. I mean, look at all these banners out here and all the good things that to get students, college students in particular, up on a Saturday morning. You guys can relate to that. Is big. So this is a big organization, and they're doing great things. Another person that's doing great things is a good friend of mine. His name is Tim Kish. You may know Coach Kish. He was the interim head coach briefly at the University of Arizona, but he's coached for years and years and years. He was at Oklahoma. He was at U of A. He's coaching the Pac-12, Big 12. Coach Kish, how are you, sir?
I'm outstanding, Vince. How are you today?
Coach, we are so grateful and happy and pleased that you're joining us on a Saturday morning. You are lending your name and your talents to a special event that's coming up in 2 weeks. Talk to us about that event.
Yeah, we're super excited. This is our second annual, I guess you could call it annual, senior showcase for senior student athletes all over the state of Arizona to come and be a part of a combine-style event. Showcase their talent in front of college coaches all over the country. give them an opportunity at least to get a college education and continue playing football at the collegiate level. We're super excited about having our second event this year.
This is awesome. It's a total nonprofit event, and it's to showcase young people, which is what your career has been all about. Coach, I'm going to turn it over to my colleague here, Alyssa Firestone. Alyssa, you had a question for Coach Kish.
Yes. Hi, Coach. I'm curious, what does the preparation look like for such an outstanding event? You know, I'm sure a lot of work goes into making it.
There's no doubt about that, Alyssa. We're expecting 125 to 150 participants from all over the state. So getting on board with the Arizona high school head football coaches, a lot of communication with them. They've been so supportive of helping their seniors get into our registration link and be a part of this event. We have 21 colleges from 13 different states in the country coming to this event from the Division II, Division III, and NAIA levels. There'll be over 30 coaches participating in the event on Saturday the 17th. We have 25 volunteer coaches. Those are high school head coaches and assistant coaches from all over the state. Four former NFL players are coaches for us at our event. And then we have about 30 volunteers. So it's a lot of preparation. It's a lot of work, but it's all worth it at the end of the day when you see student athletes meeting with the college coaches after the event is over to see what opportunities are out there for them.
Coach, we're excited. We're going to be broadcasting our show. We're doing a remote out there in 2 weeks out at Ottawa University, Arizona, in Surprise. And I look forward to having you on with us in person 2 weeks from this morning for this event. It's going to be a huge event. We are thrilled. And, Coach, real quickly, all the years that you coached, what was your favorite? Yeah, I'm sure you're going to be very diplomatic and say they all were, but you got to have a favorite team of all the teams that you were a part of. What was your favorite one?
Well, I was a part of 20 bowl games and playoff games with the football bowl division, and yet probably one of my most favorite stops was I spent 8 years at U.S. Military Academy coaching at the Army football program. So. All of them were special to me, but that one probably holds a little bit bigger piece of my heart, I guess, to say the least.
Well, there you go. Well, Coach Tim Kish, he's been all over the place. Coach, I got to say this. I'm going to use this word, legendary, for his career, the number of years that he put in this profession at the college ranks, and now lending his talents and with a little help from his friends with the senior showcase, which will be held 2 weeks from today out at Ottawa University, Arizona. Come on out, guys. It's going to be a lot of fun. We're doing the show from 8 to 10 out there, and it'll start right after we go off the air. But come on out. And, Coach, any more information? What website that people can go to get more info on the showcase?
Yeah, that's critical. So this is our website at the nffsoaz.org. And any seniors that are still interested in coming can get into our registration link on that at that website address. Okay. And you can register all the way up to the 16th. The day before the event, and then we'll have a number of walk-ups that come in the day of the event. So
there you go.
As long as they bring their transcript with them on Saturday the 17th, they'll be welcome.
All right, we'll be out there as well in collaboration with the National Football Foundation. You can even Google it, Senior Showcase out in Surprise, Arizona with the National Football Foundation. Coach Tim Kish, Coach, thanks again so much for joining us here on the Varsity Sports Show. We'll see you in 2 weeks.
That sounds great. We're really looking forward to having you out there, and we're excited to see what our talented student-athletes can produce on Saturday the 17th.
Awesome. There you go. What a good guy. Coach Kish is a great guy, lending his talents to this event and working tirelessly on behalf of giving opportunity to young people and giving back to the community. So he is definitely a pillar of our community here in the state of Arizona and nationally, very well-known coach and mentor. So joining us on the line, we have another mentor. Speaking of mentors, we're full of mentors today. Mandy Carson, she is the head girls basketball coach out at Mountain View High School, the Toros, who they're in the midst of wrapping up what has been a good season and looking at the postseason here over the next week. We'll talk to her about that. Coach Carson, good morning. Welcome to the show.
Good morning. Thanks for having me.
Coach, we are so excited. We had an opportunity to cover a few of your games this year, courtesy of Mountain View Athletics and Athletic Director Joe Goodman. Had a lot of fun doing it, and we really appreciate the accessibility that we had with you and your team. It was a lot of fun. What's this? How would you summarize the season in a nutshell?
Oh, man. We have had a rough go with injuries this year. You know, we started out super early. We lost a senior point guard in Savannah Woody to a knee injury. We got a concussion from a senior guard who has just had a really tough time recovering from that concussion. And then we just lost another senior point guard to a knee injury as well. So we're young, we're positive, we're excited. We've had a lot of young girls have to step up and take on a big role. And I think, you know, one takeaway that we'll have is that these kids that were put in a situation probably they didn't expect to be in just absolutely rose to the occasion and have just been the most coachable and kids that everybody wants to have.
Hello, Coach. This is Nash Dare with the Varsity Sports Show, and I just have a question to ask. It's been a successful season for you guys, but I just have to wonder, you're going into your last regular season game on Tuesday, and what's the plan for this weekend?
So this morning, I have a tradition. The last Saturday practice before we head into the last game, we come in, we get a shoot around, and we have a team breakfast. So in maybe the next 30 or 45 minutes or so, we've had a family be gracious enough to open up their home, and we're all going to go have a delicious breakfast together, smile, laugh, joke, reminisce, and just kind of just get that one last team bonding moment in before that we finish up the season.
Awesome. And one more thing I just have to ask. What's for breakfast this morning?
That's a great question. You know, the parents have it under control. I can't wait to see what we're grubbing on. I don't know what we're having. Hopefully something healthy.
All right. Sounds good, Coach. Thank you.
Coach, this is Alyssa Firestone on the Varsity Sports Show. I'm curious, what do you think you're going to do differently next season, after this season?
I don't know that we'll do anything too different. We've got a great program that's up and running. I think that we've got it been going for about a year. It's called Bullseye Basketball. It's for any girl that's interested in playing basketball at Mountain View. And so we've got that running from a sixth grade level all the way through high school. In the postseason here for us, our junior high leagues start right after spring break. So all three of my coaching staff will be at our feeder junior highs, you know, coaching those younger levels and getting excited about coming over to Mountain View. You know, spend our summer together, and then next year just hit the ground running with this youth that has a whole nother year underneath their belt.
That and win a lot more games, right, Coach?
The W's help for sure.
Yeah, yeah. Coach Mandy Carson, Mountain View Toros women's basketball team. Coach, thank you so much for the opportunity. It's season's not over yet. There's a possibility you could be hosting a play-in game. And, of course, we're looking forward to getting out to covering that. And, Coach, we wish you all the luck. And thanks again for working with us this year.
Thanks, guys. Absolutely. We appreciate you coming out and covering these girls.
A lot of fun. Really enjoyed it. Gosh, it's such an electric atmosphere, led by Principal Dr. Mike Oliver, AD Joe Goodman, we mentioned. Guys, when we come back after the break, we're going to have Mountain View boys basketball coach Andy Johnson to come on here on the Varsity Sports Show for the Toro Basketball Report. Stick around. We'll be right back. Go Varsity.
KDUS AM 1060 skill for Alexa yet?
Dude.
Alexa is frustrated. No matter how many times do you ask, the answer is male chicken.
Once you're ready, say Alexa, open KDUS AM 1060 to listen to your favorite shows.
Hello, sports fans. This is Dick Stockton, and you are listening to Arizona's home of youth, high school, college, and you, the Varsity Sports Show on AM 1060, KDUS, Arizona.
Hey, local businesses, join the Varsity Sports Show and promote your business on our weekly radio show and game live streams. We have several options to promote your business affordably and reach our incredible audience. Call, text, or email us anytime if you'd like more information on joining our team. The Varsity Sports Show will work hard to promote your business through our audio and video platforms while also promoting all of our young people. 480-779-9437 or email us at varsitysportsshow.com.
Hi, this is Saguaro High School head baseball coach Joe Mickey, and you are listening to the home of the Sabercat Report, the Varsity Sports Show on AM 1060 KDUS Arizona. Go Cats!
Hi, hey, this is Coach Bob Green. When I am not busier than a mosquito in a news collie, I'm listening to Vince at the Varsity Sports Show, Arizona's home for youth, high school, college, and you on AM 1060 KDUS Arizona.
We'll do what's best for the team, and we'll do what's best for you.
The Rich Eisen Show, coming to you weekdays from 3 to 5 p.m. here on KDUS AM 1060 and KDUS1060.com.
It's Toro time. And now, from the Campus of Champions, it's Mountain View Toros basketball coach Andy Johnson on the Varsity Sports Show AM 1060 KDUS Arizona.
Welcome back to the Varsity Sports Show, AM 1060, KDUS, Arizona. Before we bring Coach Johnson on, I just want to say, I want to thank the Mountain View community for welcoming us. Anytime there's a new relationship that you walk into, any kind of relationship, sometimes, you know, there's a little bit of angst, a little bit of anxiety on both sides. Not at Mountain View. They have embraced us, and we have embraced them. And let me tell you about Athletic Director Joe Goodman, who's very selfless, kind of keeps his head down, doesn't say much, and you wouldn't know it if you walked by him, except he tells some pretty bad dad jokes that he's known for, legendary on campus. But he set this up, this relationship up with us, that we are going to be covering a couple of games from each sport. It's not like heavily weighted toward any one sport. We're going to be doing volleyball for boys this spring, beach volleyball, baseball, softball. We did a little bit of football. We did some basketball. We did, you know, girls basketball. I mean, we're talking a little bit of every sport. And the idea there is to kind of, you know, spread us out there, get us raising some awareness on campus of the amazing extracurriculars going on what they call the Campus of Champions in Mountain View High School. And just a real, real good guy, great community, great faculty, have yet to meet a bad person out there. Dr. Mike Oliver, even the principal, you talk about a good dude, so great guy. Anyway, that being said, another great guy that's joining us on the line, he is the head basketball coach, just wrapped up his second season. His name is Andy Johnson. Coach Johnson, first of all, I want to thank you for allowing us access and even talking to you pregame in the hallway as the team comes out. Seeing your team with smiles on their faces, that's something that I'm going to say this because I'm a Valley native. I hadn't seen that in a few years from Mountain View teams.
Oh, appreciate it. Thanks for everything you've done for us. And we love having you guys out at Mountain View, and excited to continue a great relationship with you guys.
Coach, obviously, last year, your first year, you were off and running. You guys finished undefeated in region. You won the region championship. This year, you hit a bit of a buzzsaw in that the teams in your region were, really played up quite a bit, but also you had to retool and kind of start over, with a new team this year. But how would you summarize how the season overall, beyond the X's and O's, how it went for you?
Yeah, I'm really excited, about the future. This year was it was kind of a reset for us. We graduated 8 seniors and 5 starters, and I think it was 92% of our offense, you know, went out the door after year one.
Wow.
And we knew we had a bunch of young guys coming up that are super talented and, you know, great workers and great kids. And this was the first year, I think 11 out of 14 kids on our team, it was the first year they'd ever played a varsity basketball game. And just due to that youth, you know, we lost a lot of close games this year that, quite honestly, could have gone either way. You know, made some youthful mistakes, but, you know, really excited about the future just to, you know, have all this great experience coming back. You know, our junior class, I think, got a lot of talent, you know, especially, you know, really excited, too, about our younger levels. Our freshman team went 17-1.
Wow.
And then our JV team went 14-3. So, excited about the future and what we got going for us ahead.
Alyssa, you have a question for Coach Johnson.
Hi, Coach. I'm curious. So what do you think is going to be a little bit differently next season, or how are you going to prepare for next season
for
the future?
The difference between 16-year-olds and, you know, when you have a full year of experience, a lot of our guys, you know, just that difference of having that experience of playing in varsity level games, you know, another full year in the weight room, another full year of, you know, playing, you know, club ball and school ball, another year of just playing together and having that camaraderie with your teammates, you know, just having all these guys back, you know, for the most part, and then some younger talent coming up. When you add all that together, you know, you got to be pretty excited about where the Toros are heading in the future.
Yeah, and then Coach, I have to add on to that. You kind of referred to it earlier, but you were a lot of these games that you guys lost in were two possession games that were. You honestly could pull it out. Your schedule, I mean, your record could have been completely different.
You had a game against Mesa where you only lost by 6 points. You had an overtime game. Against who was it? Dobson might have been, but you lost to Dobson by 5 points. But just two, like a bunch of games that ended in two possessions. I mean, what do you think could have changed those outcomes this year?
Yeah, I think experience. You know, you got to go through the fires. You know, and you know, to be able to experience those things. You know, you can practice them as much as you want, but going through them in a game situation when the you know, the popcorn's popping, the lights are bright, and the crowds are different than in practice.
Yeah.
So just going through those situations, you know, together in a game, you know, it felt like sometimes there was a lid on the rim for us for about a month there.
Yeah.
You know, but that's part of basketball. And at the end of the day, though, the life's best teacher is experience. And I think kind of having that this year and going forward with a full off season. You know, excited to get on the other end of these games hopefully next year.
Coach, you look around on campus. Mountain View is a really big campus. With all that you've done and the excitement of the kids and the smiles on their faces, are the kids now starting to come out of the woodwork a little bit more? That you know, obviously you had mentioned the lower levels had a lot of success, and is that something with your numbers now being bolstered? Is that going to translate to a little more competitive fire going into next year?
I think that's, you know, it really helps when you have a great principal and a great AD, you know, that kind of share that same vision that you have where they want to see, you know, everything on campus, you know, succeed, that they're student, you know, oriented, where they want to see all the kids, you know, playing in sports and, you know, doing other things on campus. When you have great leadership at the top that shows that athletics, you know, are important. You know, it just spreads throughout your campus to your kids. And, you know, it really excites me just when you kind of see kind of the 2 years, the steps we've taken as far as some stuff on campus goes and some of the stuff we got planned coming up.
Coach, your principal, Dr. Oliver, was walking around with a walking cast for the longest time. Did we ever figure out what the quote-unquote injury was?
No, I'm still trying to figure that out, actually. But maybe one of these days we'll get the results here.
You know, we do a special segment called the Mike and Joe Show that is big on the Mountain View campus. I guess for the morning announcements, Mike Oliver and AD Joe Goodman will do this little kind of vaudeville bit, and we put it on our show. And we've had some We've had some pretty positive feedback from it, so looking forward to bringing that back. So anyway.
That show's legendary on campus, I'll tell you what.
Yeah, and the dad jokes from AD Joe Goodman, too. That's one that we could probably do with less of. But anyway, I'll talk to him about that.
Oh, definitely.
Yeah.
We all could on that one.
Yeah. Coach Andy Johnson, Mountain View Toros basketball. Coach Johnson, thanks again for allowing us access this year. Looking forward to circling back and doing a lot more Toros basketball coverage with you, your team, and just the rest of the campus community. Thanks for bringing that excitement back.
Hey, thanks so much for everything you do for us, Vince, and excited to have you guys coming up with us in the future here.
All right. Go Toros. Okay, there you go. So, guys, that's it. Hour number one is wrapping up our local show. We have another hour, and those of you at home, you don't have to do anything. You just keep listening, same station, same everything. We, at 9 o'clock, we're going to come back as a national show on the Sports Map Radio Network. Our signal is going to get beamed through our Sports Map headquarters in Houston, and it'll be carried here in Arizona as well as the rest of the country. There's about 100 markets nationally where our show runs, and it's Sports Map community is such a great family of stations and good people, and looking forward. We've got some exciting stuff. It's not a repeat of hour number one. It is totally different. I think you guys are going to love it, and we're introducing a new segment. I'm going to give you a little tip here before the rest of the country hears it. It's a segment called Karen the Helicopter Mom. You got to tune in to find out. It's going to be a lot of fun, and either that or it's going to fall flat on its face. But I'm pretty optimistic. We've had success with some of our funnier segments, so good stuff. Want to thank our guests this morning, Coach Lucas Ramirez, Saguaro Sabercats basketball, Coach Tim Kish from the Sports Showcase, Senior Showcase, Coach Mandy Carson, Mountain View Toros women's basketball, Coach Andy Johnson, Mountain View Toros men's basketball, my co-host, Nash Dara, Alyssa Firestone. Guys, thanks again for tuning in. Stick around for hour number two. A lot of good stuff coming. I'm just thrilled. We are out at on the campus of Grand Canyon University this morning, out in front of the Student Center. If you guys are anywhere in the vicinity, we've been loud enough. We have a speaker here, and we're right next to the dorm. So, guys, wake up. It's Saturday morning. Come on out. I'd like to thank Jim Howell, the club sports information director, sports information director, for allowing us to come out and do it, and our in-studio producer, Mr. Aaron Decker, one of the best in the business, been with us the past 5 years now. Aaron, thank you for all your work as we transition to our national broadcast. Guys, don't go anywhere. Stick around. We're going to be back in a couple of minutes, top of the hour, with the Varsity Sports Show National Edition here on the Varsity Sports Show Network and KDUS AM 1060. Vince, out. Go Varsity. Hey listeners, Vince DeLisio here from the Varsity Sports Show. We are so excited and honored that you start your weekends off with us. Our team is comprised of very talented high school and college students working toward a future in media. We appreciate your support, and any opportunities that we can to promote your teams or businesses will go a long way toward helping us continue supporting our talented team. We are a 501c3 nonprofit educational organization, and we use our platform to not only promote all of the great things happening in the world of sports locally and nationally, but also continue to promote and encourage future broadcasters as they grow in this industry. Please consider a tax-deductible donation to the Varsity Media Foundation. To find out more, please email us at info@varsitysportsshow.com or check us out on Instagram, Facebook, or TikTok at Varsity Sports Show, or on Twitter at Varsity Show. Once again, thank you for supporting the Varsity Sports Show, now a nationally syndicated program on the Sports Map Radio Network. Thank you for listening to the Varsity Sports Show, where our mission is to empower education and enable dreams, creating an unmatched platform to showcase talent both in front of and behind the microphone
in radio, television, podcast, and live streaming. The Varsity Sports Show, still your home for youth, high school, college, and you in Arizona and beyond.
AM 1060 KDUS Tempe Phoenix and KSLX HD2 Scottsdale Phoenix.